Packet lesson 3-8, day one, page 97. You can see that at the bottom. All right. So we already went over quite a bit of this. So what we're going to do is just jump in the pre-lesson. So you got to watch the pre-lessons, guys. Get into the habit. So here's your review. Solve x plus y equals 6 if the domain. All right. What is that really saying? Well, it's saying, think of it like this, 1, 0, negative 1, and plug each one in one at a time. So I'd say, all right, let's let x be 1. So I'm going to put it right there, 1 plus y equals 6. Well, I can see that would spit out a 5. If I put in 0, I'd get 0 plus y equals 6. Well, that would spit out a 6. If I put a negative 1 in there, maybe you'd need to have me show my work, but I'm going to add one to, whoops, that's a one, that's a one, that's one. Add one, and I would get y equals 7. You can see the pattern developing anyways. All right, so we just solved it. I'm not sure what they mean by solving it, because you could graph it, but I don't think that's what they mean. But if I did, it'd be 1, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 6, negative 1, 7, and there's the line, but I don't think, notice I missed that dot pretty pathetically, but you get the idea. It's probably up there better. So, all right. So that's your review. Now, I didn't say this, but what is that? That's my range. Don't forget that. What's that? That's my domain. Now, a memory tool. What comes first in the alphabet, D or R? Ding, 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 D. What comes first in the alphabet, X or Y? Ding, 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 ding. So you can remember, X goes with D, Y goes with R, just for that alphabetization rule. All right. So what did I say in the pre-lesson? I said, don't panic when you see this. That just means G of X equals X plus 1. What else did I say about that? I said, whenever you see symbolism like this, it just equals Y equals X plus 1. Now, what in the world does this symbolism mean? I didn't cover this in the pre-lesson. Well, I want you to look. G of X. So X is what goes in here. So if I actually looked at this and it says G of negative 1, what that's saying is let X equal negative 1. And do what with it? Plug it in right here into the equation. So this is where you're going to stick your X, or here, doesn't matter because they're all the same. So I'm going to go negative 1 plus 1 is 0. Now, what is this 0? Well, that's Y. How do I know that? Remember, I said G of X, H of X, I of X, F of X just equals Y. So if you plug negative 1 in, that was your domain. You figured it out, and you found out what y equals. You see, that's the easiest clue to look at, because you plug the negative 1 in there. Okay, so if I plug in g of 0, that's just saying let x be 0. I'd plug it in right there, 0 plus 1, and that's 1. And if I plug in g of 1, remember, that's just saying let x be 1, and plug it into your equation. So that'd be 1 plus 1, which is 2. Again, this would be my y, this would be my y. If you're confused, this is my x, this would be my y, and that's the point you found. Over here, this is my x, this is my y, that's a different point you found. This is my x, this is my y, and that's a coordinate point you found. You found three coordinate points that lay on this line, essentially. But what you're discovering are your y's, okay? Keep that in mind. All right, so what is this business? Well, as I said, it's f of x. What's f of x? Well, that's y. So I get x squared minus x. This tells me where to put in my x. This tells me what it is I'm finding after I put in my x. So this is saying let x equal 1. And if I do that, I'm going to put it in. I get 1 squared minus 1. Well, what's 1 squared? 1 minus 1 is 0. So this is essentially saying I found a point, 1, 0. But what did you really find? You found your y equals 0. All right, f of 2. That's just saying let x equal 2. All right, let's do it. Plug it in here. So I get 2 squared minus 2, which is just 4 minus 2, which is 2. And this is my answer. When you look up your answer and your, you know, your answers in your homework, this is what your answer will be. But there is more to it. You found a point, which would be 2 comma 2. There's your x. There's your y. This is just saying plug in negative 2. Let's just do it. Negative 2 squared minus 2. Uh-oh, look out for these negatives. Negative 2 squared is 4. 4 minus 2 is 2. So this would be my answer if you look up your answers for this homework assignment. All right, now they're going to mess with you a little bit just to see if you know what the letter D stands for and what the letter R stands for. And to see if you understand that this is in relationship. That's why I was beating this a little bit, this point into your head. This problem's asking you for the D. What's that? Your X's. And it is assumed smallest to El Grande. That's just kind of an assumed rule. Well, the first thing you should do is find out what these points are. That point right there is negative 3, 0. I'm going to try not to be too messy here. That's negative 1, negative 2. That point right there is 0, negative 2. That point right there is 1, negative 2. And that point right there is 3, comma 0. Now, let's do this color coordination thing. Anything in here needs to be my x's. So it can only be this, 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 and that. Again, smallest to largest. My smallest just means furthest left. Remember, this is my x-axis. So if you want to think of it, this is like a temp thermometer, but it's sideways. So negative 3, then negative 1, then 0, then 1. Then 3. And you just put a little thingy right there. Okay? Set notation symbol. All right. Sticking with this color thing. These have to be my y's. And because it's my r, that's my range. Smallest to largest. So that's my y's. So it's really my lowest to my highest. Now this is an old-fashioned thermometer sort of thing. Now you notice that these match. I could go like this and just list it twice, but I'll talk about that in a minute. So all three of these really have negative 2 as the lowest. And then we also have a pair of zeros, so I could go 0. Whoops, I'm supposed to have three of them. And then a pair of zeros, but they're just going to go like this. Even though there's multiple ones, this is what you're going to see. I know that's a little bit strange. There's nothing wrong with doing this, but they're just going to simplify it to that. All right, now I do want you to make a mental note. These are points. And the reason I'm saying that is you can list them as separate little things, okay? Now, example 4, we're almost done with this pre-lesson, is not a set of points. It's a continuous line here. It is a line segment, if you want to get fancy. But there's an infinite number of points from here to here. So we're not going to sit here for the rest of our lives and list every single decimal equivalency for our x's and do the same thing for our y's. No way. Must be an easier way. Well, we're not going to use that symbolism. We're just not. Again, if we did, we'd spend the rest of our lives writing all these possibilities. What I want you to understand is, look at the outer boundary, the furthest left boundary, and think about this. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 to the left, 0. This lowest point is, I would consider, another boundary point. That's 0, negative 3. And then this guy right here is 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right, 0. Do not forget what your domain is. Your domain is your x's. Your x's are how far to the right does this go and how far to the left does this go. Now watch this. Negative 4 is the furthest left point. 4 is the furthest right point. Now watch this. So I'm going to express the domain, not using this symbolism. I'm going to go like this. X is greater than or equal to negative 4 and less than or equal to 4. See, that's a simple way to describe an infinite number of X's. X can be greater than negative 4, less than or equal to 4. How far left does it go, basically? How far right does it go? And everything in between. That's what we're explaining. Just left to right. Now the range, remember, those are my y's. And this is my y-axis. How low does it go? This is my y-axis. How high does it go? So I'm going to stick my y right here. And I'm going to say, how low does this graph go? Well, negative 3 is the lowest point, so it's got to be greater than or equal to negative 3. But it's, and the question is, how high does this graph go? Well, look, there's my y's. It doesn't get any higher than 0 degrees out if this was tracking like temperature. So it'd be less than or equal to 0, and this is how I would describe my range. This is an infinite number of y's because there's an infinite number of y's on in this line segment. So that's what you're going to go to. Again, these were points, so I could write them as separate little entities. But this is a line segment, so I got to be a little creative. I'm definitely not going to list all the possibilities between negative 4 and positive 4. Okay? Last one, and here we go. This is just a different way to give you a math problem. Remember, what this is, because that's an h, it's just the same thing as saying h of x. Well, what's that the same thing? Y equals 4x minus x squared. These are my list of domains. So when you see this symbolism, it's nothing different than giving you a math problem like this. So you're really just plugging x's 0 in, and you're going to get 4 times 0 minus 0 squared. Well, that's just 0. And that equals y. So one, my first y is 0. We'll get to this in a minute. All right, now I'm going to plug in 1. So I'm done with that one. So I'm going to go y equals 4 times 1 minus 1 squared. That's 4 minus 1, which is 3. So that's my next y. Now I'm going to plug in 2 for my x. Y equals 4 times 2 minus 2 squared. That's 8 minus 4, which is 4. And my final one, I got to plug in x is 3 because that's what this is telling me to do. Y is 4 times 3 minus 3 squared. That's 12 minus 9, which is 3. Now, what's the range? Well, the range is my whole list of y's. And I've got it right here, smallest to largest. So I'm going to go 0, that's the smallest. I got a match here. I'm just going to write 1, and then I'm going to write the next one. And there it is, found my range. But I actually already answered it. So if you went like this and you said, hey, there's my range, I couldn't mark that wrong. You're right. But they want you to get used to this notation. And that's it.